you guys were creating something that I thought was just so fucking cool, and that people that were into Zeppelin or anything would love this band.
Right. Well, yeah. I always feel like half of that was John Theodore being our drummer at the time. When I first saw John Theodore play, he was playing in this amazing band called Golden. And, you know, I asked the band they were opening for in El Paso. Omar and I were opening for Golden as this dub project called De Facto.
Oh, yeah. I read about that.
And so it's at an arcade that has punk shows. And so I'm like, so what does Golden sound like? They're like, it sounds like an African version of like Thin Lizzy.
What?
I go, what? Okay. So I start watching them, and they have these like ZZ Top moments, these Yes moments, and then Theodore rips a drum solo with his hands, Bonham style.
Wow, love
and
it.
I'm like, this dude has the closest sounding, you know, Bonham aesthetic, but it's his own still. And then, you know, we met him, and then back and forth assembling Mars Volta. He ended up being the main guy at the beginning,
but then you guys fire him.
Yeah. Which is the stupidest move we ever made.
Yeah, I read you fired him because he just wasn't into it. He was like a bummer on the tour.
Well, at the time, he didn't seem like he was into it, you know? And I just think it came down to really poor communication skills. And when I say poor communication skills, it's like learning really how to listen to your homie.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's true, because rock people don't have that.
No, they're
just in the van, and one day one guy goes, I'm fucking out.
Yeah. I think, you know, these music schools need to teach people how to communicate with each other besides musical theory, you know, because then you'll have a lot of people staying together. But I think he was trying to communicate stuff that he didn't know how to, that we weren't listening to, and he was unhappy. He didn't want to be there, and you know,
he unhappy with the style of the band, or just touring, or what was he unhappy with?
I think with just the way it was sort of run in this sort of fascist, you know, Omar and I are right. The band. Yeah. We're in all the photos.
It always felt like that.
Yeah, and it was really unfortunate now that I can look back in hindsight, and that is just one of the worst decisions, like I said, we've ever made. It changed the whole makeup of the band. I think we've had interesting drummers since then, but it's never been
right.
It's never been the same. And his input, I mean, he's got a strong aesthetic, and he's got strong aesthetic for songwriting, and we didn't utilize that.
Wow.
It was more like, this is what it is, you have to play it like this, you know what I mean? And then the flip side of that, which were these awesome moments, were the more Omar would push him to do stuff that he didn't think he could do, he got these amazing performances from him.
Wow.
You know, and so that was some of the cool things, but you did that at the risk of fucking burning this guy out, and I think we burned him out, and we didn't really listen to him, and we just got really super impatient and, you know,
yeah,
prematurely kicked him out, and, you know, acted like a bunch of immature assholes in the interviews about it afterwards, and I still to this day see him, and I still to this day grovel and apologize.
Oh, man.
I'm just like, oh, it was the
worst. He's in Queens of the Stone Age.
Yeah, and
now.
I'm so happy for him.
I know, right? You see him
awesome.
There, he's just murdering.
Yes, yes.
You know?
And I'm stoked because I don't think people were like, I think it was like, what happened to John Theodore?
Nah.
He was playing with Zach from Rage, but that was just
Daniel
every once,
Lyon.
Yeah.
That shit was great.
Yeah, it was just every once in a while, though.
Right,
I'm like,
that was a
you
bummer.
Need to be... People, you need to be, you know, because anybody I ever talk to, it's like John Theodore.
Yeah,
John, and you know,
people
he
love
is,
him.
You know, fucking, he's the Black Paul Newman of fucking John / John Bonham of drums.
Yeah, yeah, the guy kills like Bill Burr is a huge.